Welcome back to the history of the United States Championship. If you haven't checked out the first 7 parts yet, make sure to do so beforehand. Like, comment, share, subscribe, click the bell. And now, part 8, 2010 through 2014. The U.S. champions covered in this part, The Miz, Bret Hart, R-Truth, Daniel Bryan, Sheamus, Kofi Kingston, Dolph Ziggler, Zack Ryder, Jack Swagger, Santino Marella, Antonio Cesaro, Dean Ambrose, and Rusev. We last left off at The Miz being the United States champion. At the start of the year, Miz declared 2010 would be his year, and he wasn't wrong. Successful U.S. title defenses against Kofi Kingston and MVP, then added more gold with the Unified Tag Team Championships, technically making Miz a triple champion. The U.S. title defenses continued on house shows, however, after the Royal Rumble, Miz didn't defend the United States Championship again on a televised event until he lost it. Miz would lose the United States Championship on the May 17th episode of Raw when Bret Hart defeated him to win his 5th United States Championship, joining Wahoo, Flair, Luger, and Benoit with the official record for most United States championships. This reign for Bret didn't last long, as the following week on Raw, when Bret became the new Raw GM, he vacated the United States Championship. On that same episode of Raw, R-Truth defeated Miz to win the vacant U.S. title, would defend against Miz on live events, then on the June 14th episode of Raw in a Fatal 4-Way match, Miz recaptured the United States Championship. Miz's second reign as United States Champion saw rematches with R-Truth and successful title defenses against Mark Henry and Evan Bourne. Miz would win the Raw Money in the Bank briefcase in July, would continue to defend the U.S. title with various different opponents, and during all of this, The Miz was feuding with his, quote, NXT rookie Daniel Bryan, which is still funny 10 years later, but nonetheless. The Bryan-Miz feud led to Night of Champions in September, when Daniel Bryan defeated The Miz to win the United States Championship. Bryan would defeat Miz in a bunch of rematches, successfully defend the U.S. title against John Morrison and William Regal, have a few interpromotional matches against Intercontinental Champion Dolph Ziggler, successfully defend against Ted DiBiase to end 2010, and at the start of 2011, Bryan defended a ton against DiBiase. Then on the March 14th, 2011 episode of Raw, Sheamus defeated Daniel Bryan to win the United States Championship. Sheamus would defend the United States Championship against Daniel Bryan in a bunch of rematches, one of which got bumped from the WrestleMania main show, became a pre-show match, and then that pre-show match turned into a battle royal. Now, Sheamus would work a lot with Bryan and then work a bunch with John Morrison. Sheamus would make the U.S. title a part of SmackDown during the 2011 draft at Extreme Rules in May. Kofi Kingston defeated Sheamus in a tables match to win the United States Championship, making the U.S. title once again a part of Monday Night Raw. Kofi worked a ton with Dolph Ziggler in the late spring, early summer, at Capital Punishment in June. Dolph Ziggler would defeat Kofi Kingston to win the U.S. Championship. Ziggler worked a bunch of rematches against Kofi and then title defenses against Evan Bourne, Alex Riley, and John Morrison. What was a one-time pay-per-view match between Dolph Ziggler and Zack Ryder turned into the Ryder Revolution. Zack Ryder got over on his own to the point that at TLC in December, Zack Ryder defeated Dolph Ziggler to win the United States Championship. Ryder's reign as United States champion saw a bunch of rematches against Dolph Ziggler, then basically as punishment for getting over on his own, on the January 16th, 2012 episode of Raw, Jack Swagger defeated Zack Ryder to win the US title. Swagger's reign as US champion was mainly as a house show champion, defended against various opponents, notably Kofi Kingston, Alex Riley, R-Truth, and Santino Marella. On the March 5th episode of Raw, Santino would beat Swagger to win the United States Championship. Santino would defend against Swagger in a bunch of rematches, successfully defend against The Miz, David Otunga, and Dolph Ziggler. At the pre-show of SummerSlam 2012, Antonio Cesaro defeated Santino to win the United States Championship. Cesaro's reign as US champion was the longest in roughly 4 or 5 years. Successful championship defenses against Zack Ryder, Cody Rhodes, Sin Cara, Santino, Tyson Kidd, Justin Gabriel, R-Truth, The Miz, Great Khali, even Sergeant Slaughter. At the start of 2013, Cesaro worked a lot with The Miz, Santino, and Kofi, but being left off of WrestleMania, not even a pre-show match, you could say that the writing was on the wall for him as United States champion. On the April 15th episode of Raw, Kofi Kingston won his third United States championship when he defeated Antonio Cesaro. This reign with the belt for Kofi was transitional at best, successful defenses and rematches with Cesaro. However, at Extreme Rules in May, Dean Ambrose of The Shield defeated Kofi Kingston to win the United States Championship. With that win at Extreme Rules 2013, Dean Ambrose would begin a United States Championship reign of 351 days. The longest individual reign of the 2010s, and the third longest individual reign in the history of the belt, as well as the longest individual reign in 20 years with the United States Championship. Contrary to popular belief, Ambrose did defend the United States Championship. Yeah, it was mostly on house shows, but Ambrose did defend the US title. He had successful title defenses and rematches with Kofi Kingston, and then successful title defenses against Kane, R-Truth, Daniel Bryan, Zack Ryder, The Miz, Rob Van Dam, Dolph Ziggler, Big E Langston, and Damian Sandow throughout the rest of 2013. Now sure, heading into 2014, the US title defenses became further and farther between, but being a part of the Shield and in big spots, the belt was always in big spots. And for the 30-day rule people, Ambrose did hit a defense every month. The night after Extreme Rules 2014, after almost a year as US champion, Dean Ambrose lost the US title in a battle royal. Sheamus would be the last man remaining in that battle royal. He won his second United States Championship. Now, I had almost forgot that Sheamus' second reign with the US title was kind of lengthy, not as long as Ambrose's was, but almost 200 days as US champion was not bad either. Successfully defended the title against Ambrose in a rematch, then successful title defenses against Alberto Del Rio, Cesaro, The Miz, Kane, Jack Swagger, Dolph Ziggler, Rob Van Dam, Bray Wyatt, and Seth Rollins. When the WWE Network launched, Raw had Raw Backstage Pass. On November 3rd during that, Rusev defeated Sheamus to win the United States Championship. He had a rematch with Sheamus, and Rusev ended 2014 with successful US title defenses against Big Show, Jack Swagger, Dean Ambrose, and Roman Reigns. And that is where I'm going to end this one off. Thanks for tuning in to part 8 of the history of the United States Championship. Check back in for part 9, the final part, where we end the 2010s all the way up to today with 2015 through present, the John Cena US Open Challenge, and a whole lot of the wheels spinning. Check out part 9 and every other part of this series. Like, comment, share, subscribe, click the bell, and until next time, peace. Take us home, Alicia.
don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and hit that ding notification bell so anytime they post a brand new video, you'll get an alert and you can check it out.